Welcome everybody to Vector's Virtual Week and the session Charging Completed, Application of Vector CSM's eMobility High Voltage Measurement System. My name is Boris Ruoff. I'm a business development engineer working for Vector's Measurement Technology Department. Together with Dr. Andrés Chavarría, our senior software developer and specialist for algorithm development of our eMobility analyzer, we will present you today our measurement system and the application in a real use case. CSM is our partner since 2015 and provides us with ruggedized measurement hardware. That enables us to measure in the EV development areas. This presentation is split into two parts. An overview part where I'll give you an overview on the measurement system itself, and a use case part where Andrés shows you the analysis capabilities of the system. There are lots of things changing in the transition from combustion engines to e-mobility, also the requirements towards the measurement systems. For example, we need high voltage safe measurement equipment. The sampling rates increased by factor 10, what means up to 1 megahertz. There is a need for efficient online computation and analysis capabilities for derived signals. So we are interested in power, in work, ripple peak to peak, etc. The data storage requirements increased significantly in terms of writing speed and volume. As countermeasure, engineers request rapid online analysis, the possibility to trigger raw data recording based on detected events of interest. This is a system overview. We provide data acquisition tools, PC-based or data logger hardware-based, data analysis tools, and measurement data management. We can record data from different sources, a wide range of analog measurement equipment, bus measurement technology, and ECU internal signals. And by the way, we are also able to capture the communication between the car and the charging pile with Canoe. And we are thinking about the possibilities to integrate this capability also in our measurement system. We offer a variety of measurement modules for EV measurement. For example, the breakout modules that enables you to measure current and voltage directly in the high voltage cable. Of course, we can also integrate lamp sensors or current lamps. We do have solutions for temperature measurement in the high voltage area. Type K thermocouples, RTDs, and our new system D-Temp, which enables you to measure up to hundreds of measurement points inside of the battery cell, coming out with just one digital cable out of the battery cell to the central unit. This is a game-changing technology. And we support many other sensor types with generic isolating modules. The heart of our system is the eMobility analyzer. It's a function library that is optimally matched up with the CSM measurement modules. It's available in vMeasure, Canopy, and vSignalizer. The eMobility analyzer allows us to do real-time analysis of raw data, for example, DC and AC voltages and currents. We can calculate real, apparent, and reactive power, power factor and efficiency, energy consumption, shaft and axle power, and we can analyze the harmonics. The eMobility analyzer is extended release by release with further useful functionality. We would be more than happy to discuss your needs as input for our further development. So step by at our booth and talk about your needs. Now we step over to the use case and the challenges in onboard charger development. As most likely always in engineering, engineers have multiple requirements. Customers are interested in short charging times. That contradicts with the wish of having a long battery life. The higher charger efficiency is important, just to mention some of the objectives. Andrés will now pick one of the aspects, the charger efficiency of the onboard charger, and will talk about the outstanding capabilities of the system. Andrés, the stage is yours.
Thank you very much, Boris, for this great overview on our measurement system. I would like to show now real data and to show you how to use our eMobility analyzer to evaluate a charging cycle and essentially analyze a onboard charger. So there are several classes of charging today. We have single phase, multi-phase, AC. You have communication, no communication, you have DC. You have even wireless power, wireless charging being developed. They differ on the power they can provide. The total charging time is different, but also in their efficiency. This is very important for a customer because high efficiency means lower costs, running costs. So today we will focus on usual cabled AC onboard chargers, which have more or less the same components. They are somehow connected to the grid. You have a AC-DC converter, a power factor correction, which prevents that you feed too much reactive power into the grid. This step feeds a DC-DC converter, which converts the voltage into the one that is needed by the battery. It also separates the circuit of the battery and the grid. How does a typical lithium-ion battery charging cycle look like? You have the pre-charge phase, where current increases slowly. You have the constant current mode, where current is kept constant. In that time, voltage increases slowly. And when voltage reaches a certain threshold, you change into the constant voltage mode, where voltage is kept more or less constant and the current slowly decreases in time until some termination criteria is reached, which means the battery is full or almost full. So we would have really liked to measure a real OBC, but we had no access to one. So non-standard situations require non-standard concepts. A colleague of us has a really nice charger, and he was willing to conduct a measurement for us at home. Though it is designed for toys, it has pretty much the same things that a real OBC has. It's connected to the grid. You have a power adapter, which is nothing else than an AC-DC converter, and it hopefully has a power factor correction. The charger itself is a DC-DC converter, and you have your battery. So you can ask exactly the same questions than in a real OBC. What's the input power, the output power, how efficient is it, how much energy was consumed, charged, and also the quality of the charging system. How high is the power factor? Is it feeding too strong higher harmonics into the grid, and so on. So to answer these questions, our colleague measured the current and voltage at the input of the power adapter and at the output of the charger. So if you do that, you get lots of data. Very long time series, lots of samples. If you're interested in the details, it's fine. You can zoom in and check the details, check the shapes of the signals, but they tend to be less informative if you are interested in getting information about the full charging cycle. So this is why we included into our eMobility analyzer functions that help you to get more concise and informative results. This could be powers, efficiencies, or energies. The eMobility analyzer is part of our WeMeasure Expert measurement tool. Today, we will use our offline analysis tool, because we have already the data. But everything I show you now in the demonstration is possible during a measurement, to conduct during a measurement, to do during a measurement. So we switch now to our FAU signalizer. So I opened already the data, the file measurement data, and we have here the voltage and current of the input and the battery voltage and charging current. So you can zoom in and look at the details, as I said. For example, here a typical sinusoid, voltage and a typical current of switching power supply. So you can see very clearly the different modes of charging. Here at the beginning, we have the pre-charge phase, current increases slowly. Then you have the constant current phase. And after a certain voltage, it switches into the constant voltage phase. So you can use the functions in our function library. You can use functions to calculate the effective or the root mean square values. And for example, we can see here that that the change between constant current and constant voltage takes place at 12.2 volt. So now this is only raw data, so you can do a lot of things with it, but you want to know more about your charging system. For example, you might have to fulfill regulations. You're not allowed to feed too high current harmonics into your grid, and you have to check if you fulfill these regulations. So for this purpose, we included into our eMobility analyzer a function called harmonics, which conducts a harmonic analysis. So this is how we set up the functions. It has two inputs. We want to analyze the current and use as a sink input, we use the voltage to calculate the frequency. So we will use here 10 cycles, and we want to have a result every second. Each function in the eMobility analyzer has a help page, which is very informative. Length, it contains a lot of information. It's very informative and contains a lot of tips of using on using these functions. So if we look at the harmonics, the first one here is the fundamental. It's obviously the strongest. But we find out that the third, the fifth, and the seventh harmonic are the strongest. These three ones here. We get here the root mean square values of these higher harmonics. we get also as a result the frequency, the total harmonic distortion, or the root mean square value of the full signal. So we have these three higher harmonics that are the strongest, and you might ask, well, this is only an analysis of the current. You might want to know if these three harmonics also contain power. And for this purpose, we developed a function called power harmonics, which combines current and voltage, and you decompose, or it decomposes the power into the different higher harmonics. And we find out that actually higher harmonics are consuming energy from the fundamental frequency. And actually it's the fifth harmonic which is consuming up to half a watt, which is quite a lot. So you can see also this, also a result of this function is the power factor, which is about 66%. And we see here also clearly that the fundamental contains more energy than the full signal. So this would be an analysis of the input. Now, of course, we want to know about the charging cycle, things about the charging cycle, how much energy was consumed, or efficiency. And for this purpose, we have a function called charger efficiency, which uses the currents and voltages at the input up to three phases and calculates those important figures. You can take, for example, you can consider, for example, power. And we see that the power consumed and the charging power is highest when the charger switches from constant current into constant voltage mode. This is Well, understandable, because you have a constant current and the voltage of the battery increases, so you have more power. You are charging more power. We see also that more or less 11 watts are being dissipated, which means that the setup is heating up. This is roughly 20%, and we see this figure even better if we look on the efficiency of the system. So in constant current, we find out that efficiency is roughly about 80%, up to 80%, and it decreases after the mode changes, and decreases down to maybe 60%. So even though it's decreasing, we see that the effect on overall efficiency is not that high. It's about, I think, for the full charging cycle, we can see it here in the red line, it's about 78-79%. So even though efficiency decreased, it did not affect the overall efficiency that much. If you're interested into energy, how much energy was consumed, you can use this function too. It provides you figures of the energy that was consumed, that was charged, and the energy dissipated. So for example, if we read out the figures at the change between constant current and constant voltage, we see that more or less 80% of the energy was charged in this phase, in this constant current phase, and only 20% was charged in the remaining constant voltage phase. Even so, half of the time, more or less, is spent in constant current mode, and the other half in constant voltage. So it takes quite long to fill up that remaining 20% of energy. So just a short summary of what we found out. We were able to see the different modes of charging: pre-charge, constant current, constant voltage, very clearly in the raw data. We found we could measure the efficiency of the charging cycle. So we saw that overall efficiency was about 80%, and it was not affected that much by the constant voltage phase, which had less efficiency. So we see in real OBCs much higher values. If we look on the power, we found out that power was highest just before switching from constant current into constant voltage. And we found out that about 80% of the energy was charged in constant current, only about 20% in constant voltage. This also has an effect on the time. So if you compare the times spent in the different modes, we find out that about 80% of the energy are charged in 55% of the time. So this small 20%, remaining 20% of energy, take off almost half of the time, which is very long. So if you are interested into optimizing your charging cycle, you might probably you might focus on this phase. We also analyzed the power quality and found that we have a high proportion of reactive power. Real OBCs have much better power factors of 95%. And we were able to analyze the harmonics and found out that the higher harmonics are consuming energy. Thank you very much for your attention. We got a very nice overview of our measurement system. Boris gave you us a very nice overview of our measurement system. I showed you how to use the eMobility analyzer to find out what is going on in your charging cycle and how efficient your onboard charger is. And Boris and me would be very glad if you have questions. Just write an email, use the chat window. Just ask your questions or tell us about your use cases. We'll be happy to talk to you, or you can visit our booth, our virtual booth, and talk to our field application engineers. So I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you very much.